Hello everyone, I am Chu Eun-hae working at Samsung. Welcome to the XR world. XR is one of the hottest trends these days. Perhaps that's one of the key reasons that attracted you to watch this session, isn't it? Today, Samsung screens are also taking a step into the XR world. Thank you for participating in our new journey together. Today, I'd like to talk about some use cases for XR on the big screen and briefly introduce how developers can access the XR world. What I'm going to talk about today is focused on three main items. First of all, let me tell you about why we need XR on the big screen and in what cases we can use XR more efficiently via the big screen, and then give you some examples of those use cases. And then, my colleague Heinz will describe the high-level structure of the XR framework, which is based on the Tizen platform, and also show you how to use those APIs that developers would be most interested in with sample application demos. Why XR on big screen? There are many devices to experience XR, such as AR glasses, mobiles, etc. However, while they have their own advantages, they do come with certain limitations. First, in the case of mobile, when I use the front camera by holding it in my hand, I can only see my face and upper body even when I wish to experience my full body. And when I use the front camera by placing the device far away, I appear too small to myself on the screen. Instead, when I use the rear camera, the captured view widens, but I can't see myself participating. Also, it is relatively inconvenient to visualize an activity due to the small size of the mobile screen. With AR glass or gear, there is an added sense of immersive experience, but there's no me in the scene. Moreover, I'd have to save quite a bit of pocket money to buy such a device. But if we experience XR on the big screen, not only can we see ourselves from head to toe, we can also participate in the content while engaging with the content in a hands-free manner. In short, we can experience XR on the big screen like this. First, due to the big size of the screen, the virtual object shown on the camera captured scene appeared to be much more realistic. And you can interact with control the virtual object by engaging in the virtual world. In addition, during fitness or game applications, you can also correct or simulate the form by utilizing the key points and joint information extracted from your appearance in the video. Moreover, you can also protect your privacy or convey a sense of fun through augmenting or hiding parts of the camera captured scene with XR object. Since your key points and joint information can be extracted, avatars that better mimic the user's body motions and expressions can be developed and further tailored for various applications. Then, what is so good about using the XR Framework API when using XR features? Mainly, it is that the optimized XR function can be used not only in native applications, but also in web applications that are easy to develop. It provides optimized performance with limited hardware and software resources. And you can simply use the API even if you don't have knowledge of NPU. The application's built-in recognition function can be called for tracking the user's face, body, and hand without the need for building a separate model, thereby saving you time. This, in turn, helps you quickly develop applications suiting the latest trends. Let me give you some examples. You can decorate your space by displaying a variety of objects, or you can make an application even more fun by making the object move according to your interaction. Or you can also develop applications related to e-commerce or combine fitness with fun games. For instance, when you jump, the character will jump accordingly. Next, Heinz will introduce the XR framework and API utilization, after which he will show you some sample demos leveraging the XR framework.
Hi, my name is Heinz. I'm a software engineer at Samsung. Today I'll be introducing the architecture of the XR framework. I'll also show how the framework is made accessible to web applications, as well as share a demo. This slide shows an architecture diagram representing the XR framework. The framework provides two modes of access. The first supports Tizen web applications to access the XR framework through an ergonomic JavaScript API. The second is a direct C API interface for Tizen native applications. The framework itself is designed to expose a C-based API around a number of optimized and hardware-accelerated implementations for features such as camera image capture, person landmark detection and tracking, gesture recognition, object detection and tracking, and rendering-related features such as light estimation, depth estimation, and plane detection. Additional features are also planned to be made available in the future. To make these features possible, the framework uses multiple inference engines to process data using AI-based models. These engines are optimized to make the best use of the device's available hardware. Now that we have a high-level understanding of the architecture, we will go over some basics of the API and how it is made available to web applications. Here we've selected some example methods from the API that are related to capturing a user's gestures. These methods help you to start the gesture recognition system, as well as receive gesture events through an event callback. An example of code usage is shown on the screen. To support web applications, a Pepper plugin was created to call XR Framework from JavaScript. In the previous slide, we mentioned some methods of the XR Framework API. Here we show how those methods are accessed using the Pepper plugin. We'll now move on to show a demo application that leverages the XR Framework. This application is the Ambient Aquarium experience for your living room. Images are captured through a USB camera attached to the Samsung TV and processed by the XR Framework to detect the user's location and hand gestures. Various marine floras are placed around the user. The user can feed the fish that swim around them by making a gesture with their hand. In the final section, we'll go over the upcoming release plan for the XR Framework. We'll be working to release documentation for the XR Framework Web API on the Samsung developer site towards the end of this year. It will include an initial set of beta APIs that will then be expanded upon and released the following year. Thank you for listening to our XR presentation. We'll move on to the Avatar framework next.
Hi, my name is Jihe, and I'm a software engineer specializing in 3D graphics. I'm one of the developers working on the Avatar framework for Tizen project. It's such an honor to be a session speaker for 2022 SDC. My teammate Caris and I will be introducing Avatar framework and its applications to you today. Avatar framework for Tizen is a key feature of the Metaverse experience in Samsung's largest and widest display devices, such as the TVs and the projectors. It allows the 3D avatar models such as the AR emoji, which a lot of you may be familiar with, to be rendered on your TV screen. And with the avatar representation of yourself, you can experience so many cool features. But you may ask, why should it provide the solution to these features as a single framework? It's quite simple, actually. If each application on our devices has their own avatar features, let's say app A has its own avatar, and B has its own avatar, and so forth, there will be an inevitable duplication of resources and codes among these various applications. This duplication will decrease the application productivity, and the memory will be wasted while loading these duplicated resources. On the other hand, by providing a unified solution as a framework, development productivity will be maximized. Our application developers can include avatar features simply by using the APIs of the avatar framework. In addition to that, it will be easier for us to keep the qualities of the characters and the performance for various use cases consistent. Avatar framework aims to support various kinds of avatar, but the main target is the AR emoji, which is a wonderful solution from our MX department. AR emoji already provides various customizable features. Once you create your own AR emoji on your mobile applications, it will be synced with your Samsung account linked with Samsung Cloud. Then the avatar will be downloaded onto your Samsung TV, which has the same Samsung account logged in. And you can enjoy your AR emoji on TV and mobile devices at the same time, which leads to an enhanced multi-device experience. Avatar framework allows the application developers to easily load and display the avatars without having background knowledge in 3D graphics. The application developers can use our high-level API to load and display the avatar in less than 10 lines of code. Now, what can you do with your customized avatar in these applications? First, you can play predefined animations. But with the camera and our AI technology, users can be broadened even more. Your avatar can follow your facial expressions spotted on the camera connected to your TV. And even without the camera, your avatar can try to analyze your emotions from your voice, generating new emotions and facial expressions accordingly. With these features applied, various applications on our Samsung TV can get you involved in so many different experiences. My teammate Caris will now explain these fun scenarios now.
Hi, my name is Caris, and now I want to talk about various scenarios where you can use this framework to enhance your experience with your avatar on Samsung TV. Our ultimate purpose of creating the avatar framework for Tizen is to have our users really use the technology we provide to enjoy their experience on Samsung TV with the avatars that can represent themselves. It's like being there in real life in the screen of your Samsung TV. Among all the amazing applications and scenarios in which the avatar feature is or will be included, I'm going to share several examples here today. Let's dive right into it. First, we have the avatar interpreter for sign language. At Samsung, we care about our users' equal access to information and functionality. The avatar interpreter for sign language will help our users better understand all the features and options on your Samsung TV menu. Since the avatar interpreter for Korean Sign Language and American Sign Language have already been productized, you can try it out anytime on your Samsung TV. And how do I use it? It's quite simple. First, go to the Settings menu on your Samsung TV, go to General and Privacy, then go to Accessibility category, and look for Sign Language Guide option and toggle it on. Your avatar interpreter will pop up on the bottom right corner, so just move around the menus and you'll be able to see the avatar interpreting the menu that's currently selected. Easy. Not just that, you can also change the type of the avatar in sign language mode option. Besides the case of the avatar interpreter for sign language, please note that in the near future, there will be a lot of other cool features where your avatar can be used. For example, with the collaboration of our framework and many other technologies, it will be possible to go create a 3D metaverse world where your avatars can roam around and enjoy the virtual environment together. The users can visit each other's virtual houses or host a dance party together, and so on. This experience could all become possible on your Samsung TV. Let me introduce another example. We can think about a scenario in which you can join a video call on your TV with an avatar filter on your face. And with the face tracking feature on, your avatar can follow your face and mouth movements as well, similar to what you can currently do with the AR emoji camera on your Galaxy device. Also, there will be predefined motions and reactions that you can simply press play, like a clapping motion, hooray, or smiling. Have you ever had an online meeting with your coworkers or classmates early in the morning and you just panic because you didn't have the time to shower or get dressed because you slept in? Well, in this scenario, you can simply turn on your avatar filter and enter an online meeting with a clean and well-dressed avatar representation of yourself. When developing our avatar framework, we put a lot of thought into our users' preferences and choices, and one such option was to give our users the ability to hide themselves and their faces behind their 3D avatars when they don't want to reveal their faces on camera for various reasons. With our avatar framework, it becomes possible for the application developers to give that option to our users in the apps they create, just like this scenario example of avatar filter in video calls. Your avatar can maybe be your at-home workout buddy or fitness coach as well. During an exercise, maybe you can have your avatar represent yourself on screen, or maybe your avatar can be your virtual fitness coach, giving you feedback on your form or helpful information like how many more sets or reps are left. There will be no need to schedule your training session every time anymore, and oh, it could save you a lot of money too. Or maybe you can use the stickers or GIFs of your avatar while watching a sports game or your favorite streamer. Currently, AR Emoji provides various kinds of animated stickers that you can use on your Galaxy device. And in the future, you can use those fun stickers and reactions on Samsung TV as well. Just like these examples, Avatar Framework can let our developers and designers create an unlimited number of new use case scenarios of the 3D avatars on our big screen devices. We are very passionate about what we do here at Samsung, and I hope to proudly introduce more features and applications of our Avatar Framework for Tizen in the near future. Thank you.